Hi, this is Pedro Velasco with Roll-to-Roll Technologies. Today I want to talk to you about how to install a roller on our web guides. Now, in some situations you might have that you purchase a web guide from us, but you require a special coating on your roller. Well, we don't carry those in stock, but we can tell you where you can find those rollers from one of our suppliers. And so the best thing we can do is teach you how do you change the roller, or how you install the roller on your web guide. So when we give you a web guide, when we send it to you, you will have the shafts for the roller already installed. So they're going to be located here, and they're attached with two M8 screws on each side. So just remove the M8 screws and remove the shafts. So this is one of our typical groove rollers that we have. In this case, the roller will have, when you receive it, it will be covered in a black protective fabric, and then it will have two rubber bands on the edge. So you just take the rubber bands off and leave the protective fabric on it until you're finished assembling it. So you will have on either side, on one side of the roller, you will have a little bearing, which is actually going to help. It's a pressure bearing, so it keeps the pressure on the shaft as you're assembling it. And then on the other side, you will have two set screws that will actually lock the position of the shaft on the bearing. Now, these collars kind of move around, so they are pivoting collars. Okay, so the first step to do is install the shaft into the roller itself. So you go through the collar that has the little ball bearing on it, and just carefully install it in there and just push it through, right? Now, it should go all the way through to the other side, to the other collar, and then you will have to look on it, on this side, just to align it. So, once you have it aligned, you just push it through all the way up there, right? So it goes out. Now, one of the things you'll notice is, we have to kind of center this shaft on the roller. So one of the best ways we found out is just measuring the distance between the end of the shaft to the collar on the roller, and you can use a vernier for that. So we'll just take some measurements here. This one has 0.160 inches on one side, and on the other side, should be very close to that, it has 0.181. Let me measure that again. 0.185. So what I do, this is pretty close to center. So what I do, I just give it a little tap on one side and see how much it moved. 0.166, 0.177, that's close enough, okay? So I have a 10 thousandths of an inch difference between either side. So so now we proceed to lock the shaft in place. Now, the roller face will have a little cutout in it, which gives us access to these set screws. So you align the set screw to the cutout and just tighten it. Now for this, you will need a 1/8 inch Allen wrench. So once you have it set and tightened, then you can proceed to install the roller onto the roller plate. And this is a fairly simple operation. Just align the holes of the shaft to the holes on the roller plate. Place your M8 screws on it, just screw them on. And just finish it off by tightening with a 5mm Allen wrench. And just give it once you come to a lock position, just give it a quarter turn, that'll be enough. And you have assembled, or you have placed a new roller on your web guide. Then you can remove this fabric and you're ready to go. So we hope that this helps you in doing a change of our roller assembly onto the roller plate. And just watch on our YouTube channel for more instructional videos. So you can also go to www.untitledchapter.com. r2r-tech.com and see other information from our products.